Good morning, girls. How are you today? Today, I want to talk about the kinds of symbol machines, girls, okay? We know that there are six symbol machines. We took them before, okay? They are pulley, lever, wheel and axle, wedge and incline planes, and screw, the last one, okay? First of all, we have to define each one. What is that, girls? This is pulley. Pulley is made of grooved wheel and rope and or chain move around it, okay? This is made of, okay? The pulley, girls, it can be three types. The first one here, it's called fixed pulley. From its name, the pulley or the grooved wheel itself is not gonna move. What will move, girls? Only the rope or the chain around it to lift any load or download any load. Okay, girls? This is the first one. When the fixed pulley means the grooved wheel is not moving, okay? The second kind here, it's movable pulley, from its name also. The wheel, the grooved wheel, girls, it will move. It will start to move, okay? And one of the end of the ropes will be fixed, does not move. The third kind, block and tackle, okay? It's made of more than one pulley, girls. It's made of more than one pulley, and we use this one for heavy things. We use this one for heavy things, okay? This one, the second one, the movable pulley, we can also use it to reduce a little bit the force. But in fixed pulley, we are not reducing any force, girls. It is the same force applied if I need to raise this load, okay? It's not reducing anything, okay? Here is the kind of pulleys, okay? Then we'll talk about levers. Okay? We have three things in any lever, girls. We have effort force, we have fulcrum, we have load. Again, in any lever, we have effort force, fulcrum, and load, okay? We have three kinds of levers. Okay, the first class lever, girls. The fulcrum will be in the middle. Okay? Between effort force and the load, okay? Second one, it's what? The load will be between the fulcrum and effort. The load is between fulcrum and effort, girls, okay? The third class lever, it's the force or the effort force will be in the middle between load and fulcrum, girls. So there are three classes. Only the difference between them, the place where each one is, okay? Where is the load, where is the force, where is the fulcrum? It depends on where each one of them. Then we have the most simple thing, inclined plane. It's kind of a ramp, actually. Okay? We move it to move anything from down to higher place or the opposite, okay? In here, girls, we use incline plane to reduce the force. We spoke before, if I want to make any work, okay, I have distance and force, okay? If I use more force, I will use less distance, okay? But the ramp will give you more distance. You will use more distance, so I will use less force, okay, according to the work law, okay? Here, the second or the third kind or the fourth kind, the wedge. It's made of one or two inclined planes, okay? It's very sharp. We use it to what, girls? To cut anything, okay? Like knife, like any other thing, okay? Then we have the screw. The screw, it's also modified wedge, modified inclined plane, sorry. It's modified inclined planes, okay? It's what, girls? It's wrapped in the spiral. Girls, okay? Then we have the most easy thing and common thing, wheel and axle. From its name, it's kind of wheel, and in the center of this wheel we have axle, okay, to move around it, okay? So why we use it? If I can use the axle, it's very hard. You need a lot of force to move this axle or to open the door without the wheel, girls. The wheels make it much simplest and easier, okay, girls? Here, like this bicycle here, as you can see it here, it's wheel, and in the middle we have the axle, that's it. Okay, we have compound machine, girls. What's compound machine? We only took two lines in this page. Okay, what is a compound machine? It's made of more than one simple machine. It's made of more than one simple machine, girls. Thank you for listening.